Yeah, again, I just want to thank God for this privilege to speak in front of you. So let's all stand up and let's open our Bible in the book of John. John chapter 6. Actually, the whole verse, but whole chapter, but we will read only until verse 14. Let's read this responsibly, John chapter 6, until 1 to 14. Okay, verse 1, after these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias. And Jesus went up into a mountain, and there he sat with his disciples. When Jesus then lifted up his eyes, and saw a great company come unto him, he saith unto Philip, When shall we buy bread that this may eat? Philip answered him, 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little. There is a lad there, here, which hath 5 barley loaves and 2 small fishes, but what are they among so many? And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes, as much as they would. Therefore they gathered them together, and filled 12 baskets with the fragments of the 5 barley loaves, which remained over and above unto them that had eaten together. Then those men, and they had seen the miracle that Jesus did, said, This is of the truth that prophet that should come into the world. Let's come to the Lord in prayer. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you once again, Almighty God, for gathering us here. We pray, Lord, that you will guide us. Let the Holy Spirit speak through each every one of us. Give us, Lord, an open heart, open mind to understand your word. I pray, Lord, that help us, Lord, to understand your word that through from thy word. And I pray that your name will be glorified in our midst. And I pray that you give us wisdom. And I pray, Almighty God, that use me and help me, Lord, and use as me as a channel of your blessing. Also your people, we praise you and glorify your name. All these things I ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, you may be seated. So the in this chapter of John, we can see all many miracles that Jesus did in his earthly ministry. But what we're going to study is about why people follow the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I titled the message, Why Do People Follow Jesus? Why do people follow Jesus? Now, this account shows us the different miracles Jesus did during his earthly ministry. Jesus is also teaching that things in this world are temporal or temporary, and we need to think of our eternity. That's what the Lord Jesus Christ is telling us, and he is telling these people who followed him that we need to focus on eternal, not on the temporal. That's why he, if you read the verse chapter 6, he's teaching about spiritual things, but people are thinking of physical things. And then we're going to look at here in verse number 2. Number one, why people follow Jesus. Number one, because of his miracles. It was, we can see it here in verse 1 and 2. After these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of the Tiberias, and a great multitude followed him because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. One of the reasons why people during the time of the Lord Jesus Christ keep on following him because of his miracles. First, they are curious. They want to see an extraordinary things during his time, because during the time of the Lord Jesus Christ, they saw different kind of miracles. That's why they are so curious and they want to see again and again those miracles. You know, in the Philippines, many people will go if they will hear the so-called miracle. I don't know if you still remember the Jesus Miracle Crusade. There are lots of people in Rizal Park. They went there to see that if that miracle is really true. And we know that's not true. They have a show. They invited a man sitting on a wheelchair. And then they said, "Oh, stand up. And then you can see now the miracle of God. See, the blind man walk." Yung nakalakad. Eh, kung, at may ano din, may nagbati ko sa kanila at nag-interview na talagang ano lang yon, show lang, na yung mga kakutsaba lang yan, hindi naman talaga pilay, lumalakad. But because there are many people who come in that gathering because they are curious to see miracles if it's really true. The same way in the time of the Lord Jesus Christ. Although the miracles of the Lord Jesus Christ is true, and it's really a miracle, but they want to see more in these miracles. That's why they follow the Lord Jesus Christ. They are curious, and then they want to be entertained. Like people during his time, people today want entertainment. They when they go to the church, they want to be entertained. So people come to church, especially in other, denomination, because they want to forget their problems, they want to enjoy, they want to entertain. Because if you can see the setup of some, churches, Christian churches, there are lots of lights. You will be entertained, and your energy will be boosted. Okay. So, and that's what people want to happen. And also during the time of the Lord Jesus Christ, they want to be entertained. Maybe those people, they have nothing to do, and they want to see something new. And then they want physical healing. That's why they follow the Lord Jesus. They are hoping that Jesus will solve their problems physically, financially, and emotionally. One of the reasons why they follow, because they saw that there are people who was blind, they can see, and those who were lame, they can walk. And also they saw the dead, they back to life. That's why if you read the account of New Testament, there are many people who are sick, and who can those who are ketong, no, yeah, leprosy, and those who cannot walk, they follow the Lord Jesus Christ because they want a physical healing. It's for themselves. And now this is one of the reasons why people go to church. They want to see the miracles of the Lord Jesus Christ, or miracles that will happen in their lives. But the true miracle is the change of life of a sinner. We know that there is still a miracle today, and that is the change of life for a sinner, because it's really hard to change your life by yourself. Only we need the miracle through the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why the song, I remember the song, it took a miracle of love and grace. It took a miracle to hang the world in space, something like that. The miracle will happen in our life. We will be changed from our old nature. We're going to have a new nature. So that is the true miracles. But there are people during the time of the Lord Jesus Christ, they want to see miracles. That's why they follow him. Now, the question for us today, what is our reason why we are here? Why we follow the Lord Jesus Christ? Now, let's continue in verse number 6. Chapter 6, verse number 3. And Jesus went up into the mountain, and there he sat with the disciples. Jesus Christ wants his disciples to take a rest for a while, a talk about the ministry. And in verse 5, when Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he saith unto Philip, when shall we buy bread that this may eat? The Lord Jesus Christ has a compassion not only to the spiritual needs of the people, but also to their physical needs. Although the Lord knows that these people are following him because they want to see their miracles, but still God still have a compassion to them, that he wants to feed all of them, and he did it. And the Lord tests his disciples in verse 6-9. If they really learn and trust in him, but sadly they failed the test in verse 6-9. And in verse 10, here in verse number 10, and Jesus said, make the men sit down. Now there was much grass in the place, so the men sat down in the number about 5,000. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes of the much as they would. So we can see here the miracles that Jesus did. That's why these people, they saw another miracles. That's why we need to continue to follow the Lord, follow Jesus Christ. So that's the reason why people follow the Lord Jesus Christ, because of their miracles. And then number 2, in verse 14-15, then those men, when they had seen the miracle that Jesus did, said, this is of a truth that prophet that should come into the world. When Jesus therefore perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed again into a mountain himself alone. So number 2 reason why they follow the Lord Jesus, because of his might. They saw that Jesus Christ is mighty. They can they want to make him as their king. They said, that's why they said those this is of a truth that prophet should come into the world. And then when Jesus perceived that they would come and take him by force to make him a king, he departed and go again into a mountain himself alone. They saw the power of the Lord Jesus Christ because of his miracles, and then they said, oh, we need to follow him because he is the one that can deliver us from the bondage of the Roman Empire during their time. They saw the potential of the Lord Jesus Christ. They saw the political capability of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why the Lord Jesus Christ knows that he wants the people wants him to be their king and wants to force him to be their king. They want them to proclaim Jesus as their king. At that moment, they want the Lord for their benefits. It was a selfish motive. It is not because they recognize that the Lord Jesus Christ is their king, but they want to be delivered from the power of the Roman Empire. That's why they want him to become a king. They think that the Lord Jesus Christ is their earthly king. But it will happen, but not during those time. That's why the Lord Jesus Christ ran away. The Lord Jesus Christ withdrew himself from the crowd. We know that his ministry is not of this world. His ministry is spiritual. Same with us who follow the Lord Jesus Christ. Our battle here and our ministry is spiritual, not of this world. Now, it was a clear statement in the Bible that even the Lord himself is teaching us not to involve in politics. So it is one example that gustong maging hari ng Panginoon, eh hindi na sana siya tumakbo. Maging hari ng panahon ng araw na yon. Pero hindi ayon ang kanyang reason why he came to this world. And it was siya po yung umiwas dahil kung hindi siya umiwas, siguradong tagumpay ang Panginoon eh. Pero maraming mga Kristiyano ngayon na wala namang kasiguraduhan sa pagtakbo, talagang namimilit. Pero itong Panginoon, siya na umalis. Hindi ito ang aking trabaho at hindi ito ang aking ministry. Sana maintindihan din ng mga maraming mga taong, hindi naman natin sinasabing masama ang politika. Pero po, yung iba kasi yung ikay naglilingkod sa Panginoon, ikay naglilingkod din sa gobyerno, iba po yun. Alam naman natin yan na magkahiwalay po yun. Katulad ng ginawa ng Panginoon, umalis siya at hindi niya in-entertain yung kagustuhan ng mga tao. Now, our battle is not physical, it is spiritual. And the Lord is telling us this in His Word. In John 15:19, it says, "If ye were of the world would love his own. But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hated you." Our battle is spiritual. We are not of the world. We are of God. Spiritual battle. So that's the reason they follow the Lord Jesus Christ, because of His might, because of His potential, that the Lord Jesus Christ can deliver them from the bondage of Roman Empire. And then number three, ano lang po ito, apat lang. Number three, in verse 25 and 26, "And when they had found him on the other side of the sea," ito po yung tapos na magpakain ng Panginoon, nauna ng Panginoon, lumipat na sa kabilang part ng sea, "they said unto him, Rabbi, when camest thou hither? Jesus answered them and said, Verily, verily, I say unto you, ye seek me, not because ye saw the miracles, but because ye did eat of the loaves and were filled." Now, another reason why people follow the Lord Jesus Christ, because of His meat. Yung pagkain. Dahil sa pagkain, people seek the Lord Jesus Christ because of their wrong motive. In verse 25, "The Lord answered them according to their folly." He answered them directly, pointing to their wrong motive. The Lord Jesus Christ is, He really rebuked those people that you are following me because you want to eat bread again. The Lord rebuked them and tell them their true intention in following and looking for Him. They follow Him because of free food. You know, during, kaya siguro ngayon, maraming mga taong yung pumapasok sa religion o pumapasok, nakikisama sa mga grupo-grupo kasi may nakukuha silang pakinabang. Do you know, if you want to follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of the benefits that you can get or the things that you can get from following Him, it's not a real, you are not a real follower of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are following because of the money, or because something that you can get. And we experience that here, and sometimes and there are people who accuse us that we are here because of money, but they don't know what we experience here, but that's their opinion. But for us, we know deep inside in our heart that we are not after money. We are not after the things that we can get. That's why we are here to minister in this place. But there are people, they want to follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of the benefit that they can get. There are people in the ministry because of money. I remember my uncle, he said, maganda yan, magpastor ka, maraming pera dyan. Parang gusto pang makibalato. Sabi ko, pag nagkapera ako, hindi ka ta bibigyan. And so, ganun kasi, that's what their yung setup mindset, that if you are in the ministry, you will become rich, because that's what they saw, they see in different pastor. Like in the Philippines, if you don't have car, if you don't have a beautiful house, they said you are just like you are not a real pastor. You are just a fake. Okay, only those who have car are blessed. Okay, That's why there are many young people who really wants to be a pastor someday because of what they can what they see on their on the other pastor, that they have things that they can enjoy. So that is one of the reason why people follow the Lord Jesus Christ, because of their meat. So let's recall, number one, they follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of his miracle. Number two, because of his might. And then number three, because of his meat. And then the last, why people follow the Lord Jesus Christ, in verse 67 until 69. Then said Jesus unto the 12, will you also go away? Because people went away when they were rebuked by the Lord Jesus Christ. Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life, and we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ, the Son of the living God. You know, this is the good reason why we follow the Lord Jesus Christ, because of who he is. We follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of who he is. Simon Peter said, Lord, to whom shall we go? Saan pa kami pupunta? Diba? Ngayon, if you want to, if you will sit down and evaluate, saan tayo, kanino tayo pwedeng sumunod? Diba? Ako, pag naiisip ko yan, na lagi sa iyo, salamat Panginoon at ako'y nakakilala sa inyo. At ako'y, kasi di ko alam kung wala ako, kung hindi ako naniwala sa salita nyo, kung hindi ako sumunod, saan kaya ako pupulutin? Saan, sino ang aking susundan? Pasalamat tayo at nakita natin ang Panginoon at we follow Him because of who He is. Like these 12 disciples, although meron pa rin sumablay, di ba? May matibay ditong magpanggap eh. Hanggang dito talagang sagad. Hanggang dulo. Nagtiis. We will follow you because kasi may masamang balak. And we believe, and Peter said, and we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ. Do we believe that the one who we are following is the Lord Jesus Christ? If we believe that, that's a good motive of following, and the Son of the living God. The Lord Jesus Christ asked his disciples to choose if they want to continue or turn their back like the others. God will not force us to follow him. We have our own will, and God honors it. Serving God is full of choices. We need to choose. You choose if you want to receive Him or accept Him. You choose if you want to obey Him or not. You choose if you want to be controlled by Him or not. It is our choice. That's why the question for us is, what is the reason why we are following the Lord Jesus Christ? We follow because He has the Word of Life. Because he is the Savior, he is the Son of God. And in verse 70, Jesus answered them, have not I chosen you 12, and one of you is a devil. See, meron pa rin nakalusot na pinili ko kayong 12 at isa sa inyo ay demonyo. Diba? So the Lord warns them about the devil, that he can infiltrate even the best of the best. That's why we need to be careful. So we praise the Lord for what happened in our church, although it's really hard for us to accept, but we are also in the other side, we are thankful that it happens to us. That's why naalala ko pag nagkukwento kami ni Pastor na talagang it is true the parable of the tares and the wheat, no? Meron talagang mga tinanim mga ng diablo para sirain ang iglesia. Kaya dapat maging maingat tayo at maging yung mapagbantay. Hindi naman pagdudahan ng bawat isa, kundi panalangin at makikita naman natin God will reveal it like what happened to us. Now, look at the person beside you. Tingnan nyo kapatabi nyo. Sa tingin nyo kaya yan. Bakit ay sugo ng demonyo? Hindi naman siguro. So we need to pray for each other, so that the devil will not use us to destroy God's ministry. Now, the Lord Jesus revealed the reason why people follow Him. And even in the first church that He established, one of them has the wrong motive in following Him. Now, what is our motive in following the Lord Jesus Christ? Do we follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of the benefit? Do we follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of comfort or something that we can get from the church? Or we follow the Lord Jesus Christ because of who He is? I hope our DCL, let's check our motive. Why we are here? Why I still here in this church? Marami na problemang nadaanan. Marami na tayong hinarap na mga problema. Bakit kaya ako nandito pa? Kasi may trabaho pa eh. Pag wala na. Sana hindi po ganun ang reason natin. So we are here because we love the Lord and we follow Him because of who He is. Let's all stand up and let's pray.